We're back with more clips from OTAs, and we're going to take another look at the Green Bay Packers and get a good look at Marshawn Lloyd. We're going to watch him run through some drills, run the ball. But before we do, you need to click that subscribe button right now because we're going hard in the paint, looking at these rookies from rookie camp, the OTAs, soon mini camp, then training camp. On top of your favorite veterans, some players on new teams, whatever the storyline is, your favorite players, it will be right here. You get to see what they're doing in practices. Click that button. Stop missing out on what your favorite players are doing. We're looking at Marshawn Lloyd right now. I got 45 seconds of clips, so I probably got about five of them right here. We're going to watch these a few times and talk some ball. He can scoot a bit, and he's got some thick legs. I saw some pictures of him. He's looking jacked. And that's without the long sleeves. And I knew he was thick. You can also look at the size on him from the combine. I knew it, but it's really hitting home from these recent shots. Legs are thick. Not A.J. Dillon thick. Not that thick, but looking good. Looking adequate thick. A.J. Dillon's too thick. But he's got some pop off the step. You're seeing that. Someone mentioned he had too many fumbles the other day, so I went to look that up on PFF. Around 9 on his career, 3-year career in college. So, again, he's going to be backing up Josh Jacobs. He's got good size, adjust athleticism. You're seeing the pop off the step there. He's very quick. What I think about him is a good insurance policy off the rip for Josh Jacobs because he's going to give you some size, adjust athleticism. He can catch the ball in the backfield. He showed that at the Senior Bowl. They're going to pound Josh Jacobs into the ground because why wouldn't you? They showed their hand with that. They're going to pound him into the ground. And if you got to put your Lamborghini into the shop, you got Marshawn Lloyd here paired with A.J. Dillon. I know it's A.J. Dillon. You can drop the memes in the comments. But again, Marshawn Lloyd's got some upside here with that size adjusted athleticism, that speed, that pop in the second level. The thing about him, though, he's a rookie. It's not like he's a top-tier running back out of a draft class. But he's got some things in his game. He's got good vision, and he's very electric. Going from the approach to the line of scrimmage to the second level, which is the linebacker area, and scooting from there to where he can hold it down. On top of that, he doesn't need to because they're going to have A.J. Dillon there to lighten the load a little bit. But that's in the case if something happens to Josh Jacobs. But they're going to run him into the ground. He's going to get a lot of touches. He's going to get a lot of opportunities. It's a great fit for Josh Jacobs. Josh Jacobs is going to do good things while he's on the field. I do not look for Marshawn Lloyd to get touches while Josh Jacobs is getting ran into the ground. And he may not hit the ground until next year. Could be week 3. Could be week 16. Could be in 2026. The thing about that is the Packers are going to use Josh Jacobs. He's going to get all the touches. Marshawn Lloyd is a high-end backup with a lot of upside that you need to pay attention to, who's going to get better in the scheme, who's going to be very exciting in preseason and training camp this year. He is going to be a training camp story that everyone's going to be paying attention to. When you think about him in fantasy football and you think about him in redraft terms, he's just one of those lottery ticket players. And you're just waiting on the back end of your draft. Maybe you draft him. Maybe you watch him on the waiver wire. He's a lottery ticket player. And you need some lottery tickets on your roster. The fact that Josh Jacobs is on there. Maybe you pick him up if you got Josh Jacobs. Maybe you leave him on the waiver wire. Really depends on the player pool. The size of your league. Dynasty. Dynasty what we're looking at here with Marshawn Lloyd. He is falling in rookie drafts a little bit, sometimes into the third round. Sometimes he gets forgotten about. People don't want to touch him because of Josh Jacobs. Some leagues, he gets drafted up there in the second round because he had a lot of name cachet during the draft process, and a lot of people still want to get him. Around the 205 range is probably like the high point, and then around the 305 range or worse is like the low point. I've seen it all because I just watch as many or look for as many mock drafts as possible. Well, they're real drafts in a lot of leagues too now. The mock draft season's really over, so a lot of them are real drafts. But when I look at Marshawn Lloyd here, I'm looking at a player that I can catch at a discount, and he's going in an area where the running backs really win the push against those wide receivers in the same value. Because even if he catches a game or two where he's the guy, if Josh Jacobs is nicked up, then his value is going to go up a bit, and you can catch a return on investment. If he flashes in training camp, shows some of that speed against the twos, then you're probably going to be able to be in a position to sell, especially catch him at like a 301, 303. If you love him, keep him. This is a good offense. He's a good running back. He's got all the specs here when it comes to size, just athleticism. He showed he can catch the ball in the backfield. I mean, you look at the cuts there. Limited drift, considering his size and momentum there, because the physics is working against him. So that's a good thing to see. We know he can hold it down between the tackles. High-end recruit coming out of high school who looked well with two different collegiate programs. Didn't really pull off dominant production, but looked well. I'll say that. Keep it true. Keep it honest. But he is a physical running back with some speed and some pop. And that's what allows you to hit at the NFL level. We look at running backs in 1, 2, 3-year windows. It's not a long-term game for this position. That's just how the position runs. Thinking of that aspect, that's another reason why Josh Jacobs is going to get a heavy workload. Josh Jacobs is the guy. But you're looking at him as an insurance policy or a lottery ticket. Whether you're a Packers fan or if you're here for fantasy football, he's a lottery ticket. And in redraft, you're picking up lottery tickets and you're just picking up your favorite lottery tickets and you're moving them around throughout the season hoping you hit on one. In Dynasty, he's a guy you're stashing and you're waiting and you're waiting and you're waiting and you're going to see what happens, but you know what the portfolio is. He's got good draft capital. He's got good size. He's got good speed. He tested well at the combine. He did well at the Senior Bowl. He's got good tape. He's very fluid. And he's a player that's in a good offense. So if something happens, he could give you a return on investment. Packers fans, you should be excited you got a running back like this as a backup to Josh Jacobs. A guy in your depth chart that can really turn things around if something happens. A young running back with some upside here. And he's a lottery ticket, like I said, because of the potential, like all rookies, really. But I can paint a picture on you, or to you, or for you, of how he can be successful in the league. From this point forward, he just has to develop his game and his skill set. He has to get a little better. He has to be more on point. Vision, good, but maybe a little bit more on point. Size and speed, good, but maybe we can be a little bit more on point. That's why all these rookies don't always pan out that we think of as good prospects, because there is a step up they got to do in their game. It's not like we're 100% wrong in our process. A lot of these prospects do have to step up a little bit, some more than others. And that's part of the game as well. You got to acclimate to the NFL game and new schemes, timing, new coaches, a lot of different things that you don't think of or know about when it comes to these players that could affect them. But when I look at Marshawn Lloyd and his potential, it's up there, especially with the size, especially with the speed and the blend of all that. And he was one of my favorite running backs in this year's draft class, and I'm excited to see what he does throughout his career. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Make sure to hit that subscribe button on the way out. I want to thank you for watching. Catch you on the next video.